My phone wants to Zoom me.
Us to hear your lovely voices, please unmute your microphone, and we would love to hear all of your reactions. Thank you.
No voices.
So much. Yay!
So rude.
Lots of animals. This is a zebra. This one's bison. Oh wait. Is that a skunk or a squirrel?
Wait, put it up closer.
Well, let's color them. Who likes coloring? Oh, Peter, you have a message. You have to say hi to Grandpa.
Do I have to say hi to... Hi, Grandma and Grandpa. Hello. Hi. Hi, Grandma. Hi, Grandpa.
Why don't we start another discussion topic? Why don't we do favorite...
Grandparent?
As you may know, we are in quarantine, and we basically came together to do this piece of theater because it helps us kind of release the creative energy. You know, you gotta like send it out and get it somewhere.
Three tubs of different flavored ice creams instead of
but like
tub of
you save money tubs. That way, so
it's true, but you get less.
You don't have to pay for more time. But we would love to hear your laughter. We love to hear some screaming. Hear some like words of confusion, whatever works for you, please know your exits, because that's very important in case of emergency, and please know flash photography, because it does distract our viewers. Our cast members, that's what I meant. Anyways, we're about to be ready, so whenever the rest of my fellow castmates are ready, they can put up their screens. We begin with two people walking across a wasteland. Alex, I need you to cough.
Oh, Rebecca, help me!
Yes, husband, of
course. Rebecca, I have to stop! Oh, Rebecca, we have been walking through this wasteland for 40 years, and I am so tired, and this mysterious sack that I carry is so heavy.
And you have your mysterious illness.
You've gotten worse, you've gotten better in all these long years.
Yes, that. Oh, look at all those clear blue skies.
Yes, they're clear and blue.
Rebecca, I love these skies so much. So beautiful and so clear.
Yes, dear.
We don't ever really take the time to look and see how beautiful and clear the skies are, do we?
No, we don't, dear.
Rebecca, we have been walking for so long. Yeah.
Yes, this wasteland goes on forever.
Rebecca.
Yes, we haven't seen anyone for miles.
Rebecca.
Yes, dear?
Rebecca, I have something very, very important.
Alex? Alex, admit your mysterious illness that you had mentioned to me, but elaborate on?
Rebecca, just keep doing the normal lines. I will get out. Bye.
Oh, okay. Alex. Oh, husband. Oh, I don't want to lose. I don't know what I'd do without you and your mysterious bag that never showed for your just weird ailment that you for some reason have. And now I'm starting to realize that, you know, maybe I don't know your character all that well, and I really need you to come back on so that we can finish the exposition. So, Peter, I'm running out of ideas.
We'll almost get it back. We're almost.
Alec, I have always loved you as your wife, and I always thought that you would have better internet connection because I don't know what else to say.
He's back. He's coming back on. He's coming back on. Two seconds. Alex.
Am I still frozen?
No, you're good. Alex, you're good. You're great. You're good.
Where was I? Sorry about that.
Just go from screaming Rebecca.
Okay.
Hey, Alicia, can you get some clouds on your screen?
Sure.
Oh, Rebecca!
Yes, Alex?
Rebecca!
I'm here, ready to listen.
Do you love me?
Of course I do. I do love you very much. I don't know what I'd do without you. Oh, husband, you've been...
Rebecca, don't leave me!
Oh, husband, I would never.
Alicia, what is that supposed to be?
They're clouds. Did you want more clouds?
Just put on, yes, put on more clouds. Keep going.
Rebecca! Don't leave me!
Husband, what's going on with your mysterious illness?
Oh, hey, Rebecca, you have to read me a book. Please, it's getting cloudy and we're losing our light.
Well, how am I supposed to read? We haven't had books in over 40 years.
Well, what if I told you we did have books that I have been carrying in this sack for the whole time? Open the sack! Books! Read it to me. Read it!
Okay.
Open it! Pull one out!
Once upon a time...
Wait! The title!
This is...
Hey, Peter, can I put my hand down? My hand really, really hurts.
Alicia, we're almost at the end of this scene.
But, yeah, my hand hurts.
Alicia!
The title is, The Man and The title is The Man and the Black Hole.
Now you can begin.
Once upon a time, there was an astronaut who had been sent out into the farthest reaches of space. He was alone piloting the ship, waiting to reach the end of the universe. He would get up each morning and do routine checks of the ship to make sure that everything was in order. He waited, and he waited more. He waited for the ship to complete its journey. Then one day, something appeared on his scanner. While he was sleeping, a black hole had appeared in his path. He double-checked the scanner to see if it was really there or where it came from.
It could only tell him
the computer couldn't
be in the black hole within the week.
It could only tell him
the man began writing feverishly.
Writing notebook after notebook of every beautiful thing that he had experienced, hoping that he could save it and deposit it outside the black hole's reach. He wrote, and he wrote, and he wrote. But by the time he had finished writing, he had already begun the descent into the black hole. As the ship began to touch the black hole, the walls around him started to vibrate. He looked down at his hands as they began to vibrate.
The walls oscillated in and out, finally releasing into blackness. The astronaut waited until he would come apart and fade into blackness, as the walls had. He closed his eyes and waited. But nothing happened. He looked at his hands and saw that they had stopped vibrating, that they had solidified back into solid form. And he looked up and saw a creature. He asked, "What are you?" The creature answered, and he nodded. He asked, "Are you lonely all the way out here?" The creature answered, and he nodded. He said, I have seen such beautiful things. I have filled notebook after notebook after notebook after notebook, after notebook. Notebook with them. Can I share them with you, and we can preserve them here together?" The creature answered, and the man began to cry. As he cried, the darkness began to envelop him, to pull him apart, to fade him into darkness. And then finally, the astronaut was no more.
Well, I feel so much better. My mysterious illness has gone away. I'm back to normal.
Oh, thank goodness, husband. I'm so happy that you healed.
Yeah, it was such a nice story, and I feel just more optimistic. Nothing can go wrong for the rest of the day. What's that sound?
I can't tell. Oh no, it looks like one of those rogue cannibal hillbillies that wander the wasteland.
Well, I'm sure you won't bother good, upstanding people like us.
I'm gonna kill you and eat you alive!
Oh, no. I need to run.
You're probably wondering how we got into this situation. Well, let me take you into a flashback. Hi, my name is Alex Bobroff. I believe in many things. I believe in a world, I believe in people, I believe in high fidelity. You probably have never heard of me, and I've probably never heard of you, but I'm running for president. I have absolutely no qualifications to be president, but I don't think that should stop anyone from following their dreams. I really think that you should elect me, Alex Bobroff, for president.
Or by Alex Bobroff and his campaign to win America.
Well, it looks like we're having a trouble with starting the video here. All right. Well, this has now become a podcast, everyone. This is breaking. Brock, nobody from nowhere, is now running for president. Nobody expects him to go anywhere, but at this point, everybody's expecting him to drop out of the race and cry for about 2 weeks. Will he make it? Is he completely and totally incompetent? The answer is yes. I should know. I'm his wife. Back to you, Alicia.
Hi, thank you so much, Rebecca. And I'm so sorry that you were having a little bit of technical issues. I know how it is, like, technology? What is that? Anyways, I am here at the San Diego Zoo, if you cannot see, where it has been announced that Harold the Seal and Michael the Eel are going to be united together in one space for the very, very first time since they were rescued from a freak helicopter accident off the coast of Baltimore. Huge crowds are ready to see the fantastic duo reunited. Stay tuned to see the cutest event of the summer. And now, A message from our sponsor.
CarMax.
I'm having trouble starting my own videos. Well, thank you. Oh, video's up! Is it killing you? Tonight at 11. Back to you, Peter.
Thanks, Tristan. Robots, are they killing you? The future looks grim. Back to you, Tristan.
Thank you, Peter. Robots are sure killing me.
Haha, me too.
Oh, you. Back to Rebecca.
Thanks, Tristan. I now have a reliable camera, and I'm on the scene waiting for Alex Babrock to make in a new and improved platform. Will he get through this speech without crying? Who can... Back to you, Alicia.
Hi, thank you so much, Rebecca. I am still here at the same time as you. People are, like, rioting as, like, Michael the eel has crawled up inside. It is very unclear at this moment whether or not we're supposed to be horrified, endeared, or somewhere in between. People are running back and forth, screaming, and has even jumped in to try to get the eel out of the sea. Back to you, Peter.
Thanks, Alicia. Hi, I'm here with children of Alex Babrock, Charlie McCarrick, and Tristan Lee. Now, I'm told that being the president's child has put a lot of stress on the both of you, and I... Rebecca, what are you doing on my screen? Rebecca?
Peter, we have breaking news, Peter. Alex Babrock is beginning his speech. He's starting it right now.
Well, we better all go watch it then.
Hi, I'm Alex Babrock. You like animals. I like animals. I'm sure you do. That's why I'm running on an all-animal platform. I think that animals are great equally, except squirrels. Vote for me, Alex Babrock, for president. I still have no qualifications. Any questions?
Hi, I'm coming to you live from the scene of Alex Babrock's. I'm here with candidate Alex Babrock, also my husband. Tell me, Alex, why do you hate squirrels?
Well, you see, everyone loves animals, but not all animals love all other animals. It is a well-known fact that almost all animals hate squirrels. If you want to win the animal vote, you have to hate squirrels.
Right, but animals can't vote.
Right. Next question.
Don't you think that running for office, you should know something about politics and how to run a country and not just like animals?
The poll has just gone wild after Alex's new speech. He has 100% approval. Congress has made a dent, and Alex has been automatically made President of the United States of America.
Wow! I'm so flattered! Thank you! Thank you! I'm sure what you just said was very nice. Oh, and then I'd like to thank my beautiful children, Tristan Lee and Charlie McCarrick.
Ah, gee whiz. Thanks, Pop.
CarMax!
Breaking news, because I was so horrified at what happened at the San Diego Zoo, I am giving up news broadcasting in order to become a maid for the White House. This is such an amazing career change for me, and I just thought everyone would like to know.
Oh, Dad, I love you so much, but however will you get away from that crazy hillbilly cannibal that you were trying to get away from all of this time?
Oh. That's right. Well, folks, you've heard the start of my story. Now let's get back to our regularly scheduled programming. Maestro, if you please.
Oh,
Get in!
Just a second.
Hurry up, you don't have all day.
Okay. Oh. Wow. What a dump.
Yeah, it looks like you got a real junker here, bud.
Yeah, I mean, look at that graffiti, though. I think it adds a very, like, personal flair to this vehicle. You don't really see that these days.
Interesting choice of wording.
You got killed by that murder hillbilly cannibal. What are you white bread ninnies doing out here anyways?
Well, I have an incredibly secret sack.
Mind if I take a peek inside?
Yes, I do mind.
Hey, Andrew, don't I know you from somewhere, like, being my child?
Oh, no, don't recall. Sorry.
Hey, where are you taking us?
Oh, don't worry about it. We have a camp up the way where we're gonna have you for dinner.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
It's just kidding. It's just cannibal humor. Don't worry.
It's like, what do cannibals like to eat? Adult back ribs. or what do you serve a cannibal when they're late to the party? The cold shoulder. or what is a cannibal's favorite fast food restaurant? Five Guys.
Just jokes, man. Calm down. Whoa, you okay back there?
No, my mysterious illness has suddenly come back. Will you read me a book, stranger, that I vaguely recognize?
That's silly, Alex.
No, don't worry about it. It's okay. All right, what about this one? Okay, I got it. Okay. Once upon a time...
Wait, the title!
Robert Frost.
No, that's the author.
No, it's the title.
Oh. Yeah.
All right, let me try that again. Once upon a time...
Lantern light from deeper in the barn shone on a man and a woman in the door.
Can I try that again? My phone went off.
Yeah, no problem.
A lantern light from deeper in the barn shone on the man and a woman in the door. I saw it, just as plain as white. Along the bushes at the roadside, a man's face. You must have seen it too. I didn't see it. Are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. It was a face. I'll have to look. I can't go. I can't. Doors locked and curtains drawn will make no difference. The woman spoke sharply and keenly aspired. A ring on his hand and a chain at his side. The swinging lantern lengthened to the ground. It touched, it struck, it clattered and went out. The man grasped a wheel. The fairies drew near. Then I suddenly heard all I needed to hear. It has lasted me many and many a year.
Oh, sorry, my radio went off a little bit there. I turned it off.
I thought that was part of the story. It was wonderful.
Oh, no, don't worry about it.
Yeah, keep going.
No, that's the end of the story, the end.
What? No, no. That was too short. Read another one.
All right, okay. Let me just reach into this bag. How about this book that says, do not read ever?
No, not that one!
What's in it?
It's a very secret and special book, and you should not read it if you want to live.
You know, you probably found his porn.
No. No, 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 no. I'm just keeping it to be read at a special time.
All right, fine. I mean, what about this one? Hamlet?
Yes, I wrote that one myself.
Okay. Once upon a time.
Wait, the title!
I've already told you the title.
Yeah, you're right.
Hamlet. Once upon a time,
Wait, the author!
But that wasn't a problem before. Why do I need to say
that? Please, I'm dying.
Okay, all right, calm down. Okay. Hamlet, written by Alex Bobrov.
Much better.
Once upon a time, there was a small hamlet called Denmark. It had a prince and a king. Denmark also had a number of shoe stores. In one of these stores, there was a shoe, and his name was Hamlet. And he had his shoe friend named Shoeratio. The tailor was a very old man, and it was common that he would be found drinking. One day, Shoeratio and Shoe Hamlet were together.
Hey, Hamlet! Look down!
Well, my father is dead, and my mother is having sex with his brother!
Hamlet, it sounds like that really sucks.
Yeah, it does, Shoeratio.
Suddenly, there appeared a ghost.
Whoa! Who are you? Who's there?
I am the ghost of your father.
Oh no, Shoe Father! You're a ghost!
Yes, Shoeratio was right. My brother did kill me in order to have sexual intercourse with my sister-in-law.
Ooh. Oh, no. Well, I have to go and avenge your death, Father!
Yes, Hamlet. Avenge me. Avenge me!
Well, Shoeratio, I have a great idea. We go put on a play together and get my sneaky stepfather in a trap.
Yeah.
And yet, they could not, because there were shoes. Meanwhile, a man came into the tailor's store and bought Shoe Hamlet and Shoeratio. They hurt his feet, so he demanded a refund, and they were returned to the store. When the tailor had to pay his taxes, he decided to pay it in shoes, so he sent off Shoeratio and Shoe Hamlet to the King of Denmark. The King of Denmark didn't want the shoes, so he gave them to his new stepson-in-law. The Prince of Denmark, or the King of Denmark's new stepson-in-law, was slightly miffed because his father had just been killed by his uncle, so his uncle was now the King of Denmark. The Prince of Denmark said,
I don't want these raggedy old shoes.
And the King of Denmark said,
I'm the one who pays for everything in this castle. You're going to wear them and you're going to like it.
And the Prince of Denmark said,
Fine, I'll wear them, but only because you told me to.
And so, the Prince of Denmark wore the shoes. Then, one night, as the Prince of Denmark was sleeping, Shoe Hamlet and Shoeratio went to Shoeratio and said,
Hey! Hey! Shoeratio!
Yeah? What?
Come on! I found a way to get back to the shoe store! So we can kill my terrible uncle, who killed my father, so we can sleep with my mother!
Aw, come on, Hamlet! Can't we just live here forever? I mean, the Prince of Denmark isn't going anywhere. This is a nice place.
No!
That guy caught us first. Come on, just sleep and let it go.
No, I have to do it! We have to go back!
Suddenly, there appeared a ghost!
A ghost!
Hamlet!
Shoeratio! I am the ghost of your shoe father, Shoeratio!
My father's dead! Go away!
Ooh, Shoeratio!
Another ghost appeared! Oh, Hamlet, I am the ghost of your father!
Oh, well, I've already met the ghost of my father!
No! Hamlet, I am the ghost of your real father. That was an imposter!
Wow! Real father?
Yes. Yeah.
Wait, what are you doing here? You can't come in. What?
A talking shoe ghost!
Yes, I am! Ooh, so spooky!
Get out of here! I'm here contacting my real flesh and blood! Son!
Yeah! Yeah, yeah, he's here to talk to me!
What the fuck?!
Who's that? Your real flesh and blood father!
Another talking shoe ghost!
Hey! I'm not a ghost!
Yeah, we're not ghosts!
Yeah!
That doesn't make it any better!
Yeah.
So I thought I was speaking with my actual son this whole time.
Yeah! You. Yeah!
Good God. Well, he's sleeping. I better come back later.
Oi, what's going on in here? I heard a mighty racket coming through this here way!
Wife!
Oi, that's me old husband. Ain't you supposed to be killed by my con husband?
Yes, exactly.
Oi, I missed you, husband.
I missed you too.
Longer than it really should, and I think the audience is probably getting tired of Shu, Hamlet, and Shu Ratio. We should probably get back to the scene in the car.
Restart kissing music! Restart kissing music!
No! No! Stop! Stop! Back to the car!
Tongue!
Alright.
Alright, back to
Wait, we're stopping?
Back to the car, yeah.
You're no fun.
Ruin everything.
Yeah.
Can't be pushed around back.
Kristen, you good, bud?
Yeah, I'm fine. Just disappointed.
Okay. Bring your video up.
I know.
Whoa.
That's it for the story, I guess.
Oh, I thought that was great. I thought that was a fantastic time. I mean, it did suck that we had to stop in the middle, but, you know, I'm feeling much better.
You bet.
Yeah, I thought it was actually getting kind of interesting. I like the whole part where they're making out with each other.
Yeah, me too.
Wait, what's that sound?
Gosh, I thought I ran him up the road!
We're in a flashback of my worst nightmare!
Just there!
Hi. I'm Alan. I'm the president. Why am I the president, you may ask? Yeah. I ask myself that too. All the time. I'm Alex, and I approve this message.
Paid for by no one.
Alex Bobrov claims to be an advocate for animals, but neglecting his duties to the Environmental Protection Agency, as it predicted that within 2 years, the planet will be uninhabitable by animal populations. Alex Bobrov is negligent.
Alex Bobrov doesn't care. Hi, I'm Tristan Lee, Alex Bobrov's child. Alex Bobrov thinks that because he's president now, he can make my bedtime 5 o'clock. That's why I've started a smear campaign. Let's impeach Alex Bobrov and get him Bobrov our case.
Paid for by Alex Bobrov, Bobrov Spring.
Wanting to cheat on your wife and no parents? Hi.
Red House, and that would be love.
No, stop this. I will not have it. No, enough.
I will not have it. No, enough.
Oh, thank God it was just a dream.
No, stop. I will not have it. No, enough.
Oh, leave me. That's just my dumb life alarm clock. Thanks for nothing, dumb life alarm clock.
Tired of being waken up by your dumb wife alarm clock in the morning?
Yeah, I am.
Want those extra 5 minutes to an hour more of sleep so that you can finish that sexy dream of yours?
Yeah, I do.
Well then, have we got a product for you. Introducing the Clock Blocker, literally a hammer. Now you can rest easy with this patented clock blocker.
No, stop this. I will not have it. No, enough.
Smash!
No, stop this. I will not have it. No, enough.
Wow, it worked. Thanks, clock blocker.
Call now and you can receive another clock blocker absolutely free. Call 1-800-COCK-BLOCK.
Have you or any of your family members been feeling woozy? Have you noticed sudden onsets of fur in places that there shouldn't be for at least another 20 years? Hi, I'm Tristan Lee, child of Alex Bobroff.
Due to my father's lack of insight and oversight, government scientists have been lacing drinking water with chemicals specifically designed to transform people into animals. I myself have been growing gills in places I shouldn't be. If you or your loved ones has heard Alex Bobroff saying, "Maybe if you ate your vegetables, this wouldn't have happened," and other snide comments at the dinner table about your serious medical condition, call the number on your screen now. Together, we can get him out and Bobroff our case.
Paid for by Alex Bobroff, Bobroff. Many people have cast doubts on the president, who he is, and how it is possible that he could have let thousands of people get turned into animals.
I'm a seal now. It's really sad.
But there's one side of Alex Bobroff you haven't seen. His tired side. We're sneaking into his room tonight to catch footage of Alex Bobroff as he sleeps. Now we're coming in.
We're having so much fun tonight, you know?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen,
I hope
we
don't get caught.
Oh no,
the
even
president
quit.
Is having an affair with
who
the
was
White
that?
House maid.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh, goodness! What have you been doing? And with the maid? I'm gonna leave now. Bye. Have fun. I can't believe you, son of a bitch.
Carmex.
Hello, and welcome to this, our last broadcast for the world as we know it. Alex Bobroff neglected to answer calls put in by Kim Jong-il. Kim Jong-il was very mad at him, and so he sent missiles to attack the United States of America. America thought they were being bombed by Russia, and then bombed Russia. Russia had wanted an excuse to bomb France for a very long time. Everything just snowballed from there. We will now be playing REM's It's the End of the World as We Know It, as Globes Spin, in honor of our 15-minute intermission.
That's great, it starts with an earthquake. Birds and snakes, an airplane. Lenny Bruce is not a
hurricane. I am a hurricane, listen to yourself, turn world to the
sun. Needs dummy, serve your own needs, beat it up and not speak grunt. No. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the
Where are we at? We are now flashing the overhead lights in the theater, so please begin returning to your seats just to get ready for top of Act 2. Flash, flash, light, light.
What's going on? Where was all that music coming from for 15 minutes? What's happening? Rebecca? What?
Alex? Alex, are you okay?
What? What?
Alex, we crashed the car and they took us to their underground city.
What? Rebecca, I can't move my hands. Why can't I move my hands, Rebecca?
Alex, it's gonna be okay.
What will be okay? What?
Let me just show you in a mirror.
What's happened to me?
They had to transfer your brain and your new body. You should be okay. You should be able to move your arms in a few minutes.
How can you let this happen to me?
This is only temporary, Alex. They're just improving your old body and adding some retrofitting to spice it up.
Well, so long as I get my body back once they're done. Oh, look, I can move my hands again.
That's great, Alex. Now we can go take a walk in the big underground city.
Yeah, let's go. Let's just hold on. Oh, okay. Wow. Look at all those kooky characters.
Yeah, characters sure are kooky.
Oh, wow, look at that one.
Ew, gross.
Why are there so many?
They must have been the ones to make the city down here.
Ah, travelers from a far-off land.
That mutant speaks!
Ah, but I am no mutant. I am a fortune teller.
Sounds pretty mutant to me.
Yes, because of the name calling, I'm just going to assume you are travelers from a far-off land. Above ground, perhaps?
What? How did you know that? You must really be a fortune.
Yes? You were saying?
Peter. Can we stop?
Just keep going. Just keep going. It'll be fine.
Okay. Are we just using his...
You guys still have pictures of Alex that we used to use for Act 2, right?
Yeah.
Okay, can you pull those up and then just read his lines and then, like, I don't know, play off the, I don't know, just, yeah.
Where are we going from?
He stopped off travelers from a farm land or something, I don't know.
Okay, you must be travelers from a far off land, above ground perhaps. Wow, she really must be psychic.
Or she just saw that we're not mutant hands.
Come inside my shop and fondle my wares.
All right. I'm just telling you, we're just passing through. Just passing through.
Oh, that's great. Just wonderful. Simply splendid. A truly marvelous, fantastic hunk of baloney. Who, baloney? I haven't had baloney in over 40 years. No one has. No, I see baloney in you. You are full of it.
Lady, that's my husband. Let the spooky woman talk, wife. Okay, husband.
You don't want to move on. You really want to come in and look at my shop for an extended period of time. Wow, she's right, I do.
Yeah, real impressive.
I know many things that would surprise you in my infinite wisdom.
Is that so? Wait, don't I know you from somewhere, like fucking my husband or something like that?
Excuse me. That is so rude. Like, I have never met both of you before today, so I don't even...
Okay, great.
What?
Alex is back. Keep going. Wait. You can take down the pictures.
Where were we? 24. The first line, Mystic Woman, where should we go next?
Oh, Mystic Woman, yeah.
Okay, sorry. Oh, Mystic Woman, where should we go next?
Ah, peculiar puzzle you hold for me. Let me close my eyes to look and see.
Oh boy, finally, Rebecca. I wonder if it will have to do with this mysterious sack of books that I carry with me.
Well, if you say it out loud, she's gonna know that
I see that your mysterious sack is full of books.
Oh, wow, how does she do it?
It's a gift that few have and even fewer can master.
You literally just said that you have books.
Shh, Rebecca, don't spoil it for her.
Ah, but the vision does not concern the books. I see a throne where they should sit, atop of which you will not hit, lest you win 24% or more, a thing to win above all scores.
Wow, poetry. What does it mean?
I hear them tell there is that is, a place we see, a place there is. The city we reside in here holds elections once a year.
Wait, you're telling me that I could be president of this underground city?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Don't you think that's a bad idea?
No.
Alex, don't you remember what happened last time you became president?
No.
What happened, folks?
Well, off to go win an election.
Wait, don't you move, sir. Before you go to win the vote, shouldn't you give me something you wrote?
Nope. Goodbye.
Alex Bobroth, mistaken you must be. I must read a book you give to me.
No. Goodbye.
Peter?
What?
Alex isn't giving me the book to read. Like,
well, yeah, we cut it.
But I still want to read it.
Alicia, no, we cut it from last
week. Alicia, we have a show going on.
Yeah, Alicia, we have a show going
on. All right, stop it, stop it. Stop it. Okay, all right, we're doing the candidate montage. Do the candidate montage.
Peter, I don't think the candidate montage has been working very well.
Yeah, the montage is a little funky. I don't think we should do it.
Well, we should have taken it out sooner then, shouldn't we?
I know. Right. Whatever, let's just do it.
All right.
Not even in the right.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Oh, where'd my line go? Underground City newcomer Alex Bobroth enters the race for Underground City president. Extra, extra.
Hi, I'm a former attorney at law. The radiation has given me three arms and a ripped hole in my spine. But that doesn't mean I don't want what's best for you. I believe in healthcare for every underground citizen. I believe in a $15 minimum wage. A vote for the weird head is a vote for you in the future of the underground city.
Hi, I'm a flashlight, a sentient flashlight. I've been working all my life as a career politician. Now, I know that may be hostile to many of you, but I think it gives the person the ability to say a thing or two about how our system can run. I know that with a little hard work and elbow grease, we can get things going on track. That's why you should vote for me! A vote for the flashlight. Shine a light and get it right.
Hi, I'm an orange. You should vote for me.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Big debate tonight between all of the candidates.
And in conclusion, that's why I think we should spend more responsibly on fossil fuels and begin to move to a cleaner energy.
Well, I agree. Clean energy would be nice. We have to think of our people first.
Alternative energy? I just don't see the appeal.
Extra, extra, read all about it. All Bobroth opponents have either dropped out of the race or been eaten by large hands. Congratulations to the new supreme leader.
Wait, I've received word that any second now the cannibal murder hillbilly will breach the ceiling and kill us all. We need to stop the ceremony and evacuate the city now.
That seems pretty far-fetched. Let's keep going on as we have been.
Wait. I remember now. That man is my father. That man was the president and is the reason why the world is this way. We need to stop him now.
The guards! Suppress dissent!
No! No, police! No!
Hi, I'm Alex Barbara. I would like to thank you fine people for choosing me as your new leader. I know that my reign will be long and prosperous, and nothing bad will happen in it at all. Well, in order to get into this wonderful new reign with myself as king, I mean president, before we begin, I have someone very special who will be reading us a wonderful story to commemorate this event.
Oh my gosh, Alex, it is such an honor.
Alicia, go away. Our very special guest star, the Pirate King.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you for this opportunity.
Well, yes, of course, little man. Oh, look at him, so grateful and thankful. I think we can all take a page out of his book.
You mean the book I'm going to read for all these nice people? Huh. Yes, that's it, little man.
Oh, goodness me, what a gorgeous little guy.
No, you.
Oh, you.
Oh, please stop it.
Quiet on set.
Well, little man, want to begin?
Of course, Governor. Once upon a time.
Wait, the title.
Oh, yeah, silly me, always forgetting to tell the title.
Oh, you.
Well, the title is The Stupid Idiot Who Became President, even though he had no qualifications to do so, and he was really bad at his job, and everything ended up going to shit, even though he tried to make it seem like it's fine.
Wow, I'm interested.
Once upon a time, there was a man who had won an election of an underground city, and he didn't realize that the city he had inherited was about to collapse in on itself by an evil, hillbilly murder cannibal. And it was because he had decided that he would ignore things that other people would tell him. And they were smarter than him, and he would just ignore them. And the man had won an election before, and he was equally as incompetent at that. The man also had dashing brown curly hair and glasses.
Wait. I have dashing brown curly hair and glasses.
Oh, then I must be talking about you then.
Wait. I never told you about the mysterious sack of books. I don't tell anyone about that.
What mysterious sack of books?
Wait. If you're not reading a book, if you're not reading one of my books, then what will you be reading?
Did he?
Peter,
is he gone?
Can we stop now? It's kind of a big part.
And she starts reading it, and the book is
What did you just say? I like missed out on like the
last.
Alicia
picks up a book and she starts reading Julius Schuster. She starts reading Julius Schuster. Yep. Once upon a time, etc., etc.
Book. Once upon a time, there is.
Whatever.
I'm reading a story about Julius Caesar. Once upon a time, there was a shoe who wanted to become the greatest shoe leader in all of Shoom.
Aha, I have a violin and I like playing it while my country burns.
A lot of the other shoes didn't like him.
Oh, I don't like him. He plays his violin while his country burns.
So they decided they wanted to come up with a master plan to take the shoe out. And they planned for days, about where he was going, what he was going to do, how he would react. Except that they weren't really thinking about how he was going to react. It was more of how they were going to execute it. So one day, when Julius Caesar was playing his violin, the other shoes snuck up on him.
Violin! Oh, shoe! Julius Caesar! I'm a shoe!
Stab, 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 stab.
Yeah, I've been stabbed. Oh, I'm a shoe. And I've been, oh, I'm so stabbed, stabbed. Oh,
all the shoe parts were coming out. His laces were coming out. The bottom of his heel was coming out. Even the arch thingy for people's feet was coming out as well.
Oh, my arch.
We're stabbing you with the shoe, with the knives that they sell online that say they can cut through shoes.
I've been cut through a shoe by a Ginsu knife. Oh, what a hard time. Oh, my soul. Oh, my soul is gone. I have no soul. Oh, I'm dead. I'm dead. Oh.
He couldn't help but think for his last final words, what a world. What a world. What a small world after all.
You are now dead, surely a shoeser. We have killed you, and now me, Shute, is now going to help rule Shrom.
Yeah. All the shoes loved this shoe, except for one person, who was actually his best friend.
That's me?
Yes, that's you.
Oh, I'm sorry that I stabbed you to death, Julius Schuser, but you have to understand for my predicament. I've been forced to carry this through, you know, I was picking up in a black, dark area and then thrown into a world of fire, which yeah, I'm sure you can only understand since your background was really similar. But, oh, Julius, I don't know if I can take it anymore. I need to run into the disaster of the world around me.
And so the shoe ran, and then somehow, instead of dying, the shoe went to Shurona.
Oh, where is everyone? Where? Who is that?
I'm the ghost of Abraham Lincoln. Ooh, I'm a sock. Abraham Shoe Lincoln. Ooh.
Abraham Shoe Lincoln.
Ooh, yes, I have come with a message of warning. A warning from the past. Do not eat avocados. They have too much cholesterol. Ooh.
I don't even know if I can digest such a thing.
Well, in the future, when you can start digesting things, as shoes
stop
will do...
Stop this right now! My name is Stephen Sondheim. I'm a legendary composer and lyricist for the musical theater. And I am here to tell you all that you are not doing Shakespeare as he was intended to be done. And I am now going to write a new musical about this version.
So you're going to write a musical about shoes?
Fantastic.
Of course. I mean, the musical about
shoes.
Great, Alex, can we finish with the Pirate King, what the Pirate King was saying? Can we go back to that, and then we'll do the whole Coliseum bit?
Thank God he's
been yeah.
I actually thought that was okay. Stephen Sondheim. I was, like, getting really excited for him.
Yeah,
what are you, a child?
Alicia? I'm concerned if you thought that was really... where should we go from?
I mean, it's not every day you see a celebrity.
All right, let's go.
Hey,
go.
Wait, how could you read that book that says the city is going to cave in? I never told you about my mysterious sack of books. I don't tell anyone about that. What mysterious sack of books? Wait, if you're not reading a book, then...
Oh my God.
Is he gone again?
I'm going to...
I mean, to be fair, this is the funniest thing ever.
Agatha, I'm blind, oh, and I can't. The TV.
I'll fix this.
How do I work with the Zoom play? Agatha.
Yes, sweetie.
No.
What are you trying to point?
Did you turn it off and on again?
To turn up the
Christian, who are you supposed to be?
Don't worry.
Did you turn it off and on again?
I'm trying, Agatha. Is that what this is?
Yes, Alex is back. Alex is back. Please stop.
Okay, great. Fantastic.
What's right,
Alex,
what's time?
Before the internet. No, Alex, come back.
Where'd he go?
No!
Rather, all this crash and burn, see what happens. I don't think you need me anymore.
Alex, no.
Fine. How can you read the book? You know, I never told you about the books. What books? Wait, if you're not reading a book, what are you reading?
a newspaper. Oh no! The city! It's caving in!
Oh no!
Wait, what is that I hear?
It's that laughter!
I'm going to kill you all. What's that?
Oh no, giant claws are caving in!
Murder house of evil. It is time for you, Alex Bobrov, my one true enemy this whole time, to die in my third murder Thunderdome of Doom by the hands of your own child.
Hi, Dad.
No, no, not my son.
Yes.
Yes, your son. Ha ha! They decided to betray you.
You would never listen to me. So I had to sabotage the underground city to test you, to see if you've learned to listen to others when they tell you things, like a cannibal coming down from the ceiling.
But...
Yes, and you failed!
Okay, that's enough of him. That's right, cannibal murder hillbilly! I'm betraying you! You'll never get my daddy. Guards! Throw him in the black hole. Yes. He's dead now.
Oh, thank you so much, son. You've saved me!
Yeah, Dad. That murder hillbilly will never kill you. I will.
What? No! Son, don't!
Yes! Yes, Father! And I won't do it alone. I have the power of everyone with me!
Me.
No!
What do you have, Father?
No. Well, I have fisticuffs!
What? Brute force! Everyone run and hide!
Wait, I can't hide!
I've got you cornered, Alicia!
No, no, please, just cheat on your wife with me and let me live!
No!
Ah! Oh, I'm dead.
Hey! Rebecca! Rebecca! Come here! Come out wherever you are!
Husband, haven't I been good to you? Haven't I been a good wife, always supportive?
Oh, you know what? You have, wife! Too bad I'm on a rampage! I beat my wife!
No! Oh. Father, you can't say that kind of thing! People are watching!
Oh, you're right.
Shit!
Sorry.
I've revealed myself. Don't hurt
me.
I'm your
father.
Hi! Please don't kill me.
That's everyone!
Oh my
god! Wait. What's over there? What is that? Says it's a mysterious lever that says, do not pull.
No! Don't pull that lever! Whatever you do.
I'm gonna pull it.
No! Don't! You'll kill us all!
I'm gonna do it!
No!
Too late!
Rumble, rumble, rumble,
rumble, rumble, rumble, rumble, rumble, rumble, rumble, rumble, rumble, rumble, rumble.
That sound! What's going on? What happened to my background?
That's a lever to the cage where we keep all of the characters in the play!
Hi, I'm an orange! I'm gonna peel you to death! Damn. Come on, get that vitamin C! Ah! Oh. I'm Michael the Eels!
Hey, dude!
I'm gonna get you!
I'm the monster who eats light! And by light, I mean small portions. If you give me a bean, I'll be satisfied for at least a couple of months.
Did you kill my husband? Because if you kill my husband, I'm gonna get you.
I'm a phallic mountain that has appeared multiple times.
That was everyone! I did it! Now where did I put my sack?
You forgot one
Wait, Charlie? Charlie, what are you holding my sack over that black hole for?
Carmex?
Oh, Charlie, just come over here. Come over here with the sack. I can't do the fruit puppet. Come over here, Charlie. Come on. No, you don't need to. No, don't drop it. Charlie! What have you done? No! No! Why did you do that?
Carmex.
No! You stupid idiot! Can't you say anything other than Carmex?
No!
Good thing I had this mysterious sack of books to break my fall. Ah. Where am I?
Hello, Alex.
Who are you?
I'm the last thing that you're ever going to see.
Well, what's going to happen to me?
I'm going to eat you.
And am I going to die?
Yes.
Wait, before you eat me, I have one request. These books have gotten me through a very, very tough time. They have comforted me in illness. They have been a light in these dark times. And will you read one to me?
I don't see how it could hurt.
Here. This one.
Once upon a time, there was a little boy.
Wait. The title.
The Sick Little Boy and the Well.
Thank you.
Once upon a time, there was a little boy, and he had been very sick for all his life. He wasn't allowed to go outside and play with the other children because his illness made him so frail. The little boy grew lonely inside and wished to go explore the woods beyond his house. But his mother wouldn't let him because it was dangerous. One day, the boy decided that he would go and see the woods for himself. So in the middle of the night, with a sack and a stick, the little boy set off into the woods. As he began, things went well, until he tried to find his way back home. The more he tried to find a path back to his house, the deeper he found himself in the woods. He kept searching and searching, until finally he came across an old abandoned well, where he sat down and cried, afraid that he would never see his mother again. As he was crying, a figure approached him from the woods to comfort the boy. The boy asked, "Who are you?" And the figure answered. The boy asked, "Where are we?" And the figure answered. The boy asked, "What's going to happen to me?" The figure answered, and the boy began to cry. And as he was crying, the figure reached into the well and pulled out the books. The figure placed them in the boy's sack and told him that they would cure his illness for a time, but he warned that there was one marked book that if anyone read, even a sentence, their story would be sucked out and they would become a book. The figure wiped the boy's eyes, hugged him, and held him close. The boy asked the way home. The figure told him, and the boy went on his way. The figure stayed at the well, watching the boy walk off into the sunlight. The end. Is this that book?
Yes, it is.
Well played. How long does it take to work?
A few more seconds.
Tell me, you've had this all this time. Haven't you read it, looked at it?
Well, like your time was up. Well, to answer your question, I can't read. Hooray! I did it! I beat the monster! Guys? Oh, that's right. There's no way out of here. Well, good thing that when you pull out the sleeve of the book... Ah, time enough at last! Ah! My glasses. My glasses. I can't find my glasses. No. No. No!
Thank you all.